Hello everyone, my name is Patrick Kunzmann and I would like to give you a short update on the progress of the BioTED project since the last talk at BOSC 2019, with focus on four distinct new features. To get you into the topic, BioTED is a comprehensive Python library for sequence and structure analysis. In principle, it is inspired by BioPython, but it aims to achieve a higher performance by representing sequence and structure data by number arrays, allowing vectorized operations. For time-consuming tasks, where vectorization is not possible, the performance is increased by extensions written in C. The first new feature I would like to show you is a bridge from BioTED to the PyMO Molecular Visualization System, which is available in the BioTED extension package Emolite. It allows the user to directly transfer atom arrays, which are the structure objects in BioTED, to PyMO and back again without intermediate files. Furthermore, you can use the same NumPy-oriented atom filtering BioTED uses, also for atom selection in PyMO, and display rendered images in Jupyter Notebooks. As an extra, we created also a conda package for open source PyMO, which is automatically used for the conda installation of Emolite. In summary, Emolite gives you the convenience to perform structure data analysis and visualization from the same script. The next functionality is an interface to AutoDockVena for molecular docking of small molecules to receptors. AutoDockVena is a popular software that requires a special PDBQT file format for input and output, usually read and written by scripts in AutoDock tools. However, these scripts run on the now deprecated Python 2.7. BioTED provides a seamless wrapper around AutoDockVena based on its own new PDBQT writer in Vida, allowing the user to dock a ligand with a single line of code without the requirement of AutoDock tools. BioTED now also has the ability to perform specialized structure analysis for nucleic acids. The new functions allow to detect which nucleotide residues form base pairs or have stacking interactions. The obtained base pairs can be converted into dot bracket notation for usage within external software tools. In this process, BioTED is able to detect pseudonods and optionally remove them. But instead of using the structure to determine base pairs, BioTED can also predict these from sequence using the Vienna RNA package. For visualization of the nucleotide secondary structure, BioTED provides a plotting function for matplotlib, harnessing its large variety of available output image formats. In addition, pseudonod interactions and the sequence position labels can be added to the figure. Last but not least, BioTED has got a modular construction kit for heuristic homology searches, following the example of BLAST and similar software. Most of these programs implement very similar steps to find and align similar sequences from a large database to a given query sequence. In brief, we have a fast K-map matching process between the query and the database sequences, an ungapped extension at the hit position, and finally a time-consuming local gapped alignment. Between these steps, only the most promising hits are filtered and considered in the next step. BioTED provides classes and functions to perform each of these steps in an easy manner, here shown in gray. BioTED's K-map table is used to index the K-maps of one sequence and match them to exact or similar K-maps of another sequence. Then BioTED's alignment functions are used to create an ungapped or gapped alignment, either using the XDROP or band heuristic. Although the computational performance of dedicated homology search software is not reached, BioTED instead offers a flexible toolkit to prototype new ideas or to tailor a custom alignment software for a specific problem, ranging from homology searches to read mappings. Thanks to the other contributors, BioTED has evolved in many more aspects I could talk about, but for now this ends my presentation. For a deeper dive into BioTED, I would like to refer you to the official documentation. We always look for new contributors, so if you're interested now, I look forward to getting in contact with you on GitHub. I would like to thank the BOSC organizers for the opportunity to give a talk, and I thank you for your attention.